As a contractor, how do you see waterproofing as a very essential part of, you know, constructing the building?
As contractor, we are supposed to build client's dream, architect's specifications, and at the end of the day, client, architect, everybody expects the onus of the deliverable lies on us, whatever they're specifying. So when somebody asks for a 10 years guarantee on waterproofing, so indirectly they're asking us to vouch for it. Right, because at the end of the day, it is in my kitty that you have to do this kind of waterproofing and give me a warranty of 10 years. In return, I always ask my waterproofing expert that you have to give me a 10 years warranty. He may not be in the same business, but I am still there in the same business. So I have to vouch for it. So it is very integral for us to find the right solution. If it is not specified, then also go back to the client, go back to the architect that was whatever you have specified is not the appropriate solution. And if you want the 10-year warranty or guarantee, then this should be the right spec.
So Rahul, as a contractor, what kind of challenges do you face being, you know, the contractor and being convincing the other person?
Like I said, I am an architect by qualification. So I do understand specification much better than other contractors, I would say. And that helps me in convincing my client. So client, I mean the actual client who's going to pay, the architect who's going to specify, because at the end of the day, architect is also my client. He's going to take that decision. I have to vouch for him as well, because at the end of the day, we are from the same fraternity. I cannot backstab my fraternity.
Right.
So we help each other. And at the end of the day, if there is no seepage, then everybody is happy.
How to get that no seepage thing in the home?
Right specs. Absolutely. See, in the projects, we, like I said, you want a guarantee warranty for everything. And if I have to give that, probably if we talk sense, if I'm talking some rectification measures or some correction, some tweaking, everybody listens because that's for the betterment of the project, for the deliverable. And at times, if it is going to cost some extra money, they don't mind. Because now, with a lot of exposure, with a lot of internet penetration, everybody is concerned that, oh yes, that's a problem. It's going to seep in when everybody will be out. And then there would be nobody for client to help him. So client is going to, at best is going to go to the architect. Yaar, ye kya ho gaya? Ab main kya karun? Client will say, arre, contractor ko dhundo. Kahan hai contractor? Contractor will say, maine nahi ki thi waterproofing. Waterproofing usne ki thi. Usko dhundo. So, अगर हमें कंटिन्यूस बिजनेस करना है सो हमारे पास आके बॉल रुक जाएगी. यस, एंड दैट, एंड फिर वो प्रॉब्लम आनी ही नहीं चाहिए.
सो रॉल, माय क्वेश्चन हियर इज, 14 15 20 साल पुरानी बिल्डिंग है, फ्लैट लिया हुआ है और वहाँ पे सीलन है. सो व्हाट इज द सॉल्यूशन टू दैट, बिकॉज इट्स अ 15 ईयर ओल्ड बिल्डिंग, यू नो, व्हिच हैज बीन कंस्ट्रक्टेड. सो हाउ कैन वी जस्ट गो बैक टू द वाटरप्रूफिंग थिंग?
इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रेट्रोफिटिंग, सो रेट्रोफिटिंग, there are two kind of things. One is data which is available in the form of as-built drawings, if at all it is there. Usually that is not the case. Most of the times constructed projects or older projects, they don't have any documentation, at least for the waterproofing per se. They might have few drawings. So generally, if it is not there, then we try and remove patches. With that, we try and understand what kind of waterproofing was there. And with the age of the building and with the help of experts, waterproofing experts, we try and gauge what would be the stage where, whether it needs overhauling, we need to remove everything, rip apart, we take out the filling, we take out the pipes, and we do 100% waterproofing, or we can do patchwork. So that is only possible when we do a sampling. We remove a patch, we take out, and we try and see if there is any leakage or seepage happening. From, and we try to find root causes for that. Primarily traps, we try and open the traps. We look whether the traps have loosened up their grouts, which is allowing the water to seep into the slab. And water doesn't need any root. With capillary action, water can travel from ground floor. The seepage can happen in ground floor and it can affect the 10th floor or 12th floor.
Right.
So that's what we do for retrofitting as well.
Thank you so much for being with us, Rahul. Thank you.
Thank you.